Hi there, I'm Chris Noring. In this video, we'll talk about Vue and the computed values. The first thing we need to know about computed values is that they are a computation. And what does that mean? Well, there are different ways to compute values. So if you have a look at this code in here, you see two computed values. First off, we use the keyword computed to place these values inside of our component. And then we define the computed values that we want. In this case, we have two different computed values. One is called sum, and the other one is called full address. Now with the sum, you can see that I'm returning a value, and that return value is the composite, or it consists of more than one value that we do return. You can see that I'm returning LHS, which stands for left-hand side, and RHS, or right-hand side. And the whole idea of this computed value is to show the sum of a calculation. In the second example, we see full address, and full address takes a name, an address, a city, and a country. And the final result is a full address, like you want to show on a sticker on a package, for example. So now that we've seen what we can do with code, we should know one more aspect. It's not just about showing off multiple values, but also to rely on the fact that they are reactive. And what does that mean? Well, when something is reactive, it means that if you were to change any of these values, this one or that one or both, this one would actually be reflected. It means it would be updated. We will soon see that in the browser, how that would work. But it's good to know that if we point out or rather create a computed value, were we to change any of the dependent values, we can ensure that Vue will investigate and say, aha, this has changed. I better change too. Let's move on to the browser. Now in our browser here, if you look to the left, you see that we have one, the address sticker, and two, we have the calculator. And here we have the sum computed value, and here we have the full address. So let's try the first one. We have the calculator and we say, I'm going to make you a one and you into a two. And from what we can see here, we see that the sum is being updated. So why is that? Well, if we look at the file itself, the index.js file, we can see when that happens. So every time we try to change this, let's say we increment it, we see that this computed field, the sum field, is being invoked, and it has a chance to recalculate the value. So we see that it takes the value of left-hand side and right-hand side and try to do a new summation of this. And as you can see, the final result is the new sum, which is 5. We do the same thing here. We see immediately how this field start updating. And as you can see, the final result is how this computed field is doing its job for us. Because after all, what we want computed fields for is the ability to create dependencies between one or many fields. And we want those fields to calculated field to be updated every time we change one of the dependencies. So were I to change the address, I want to see the change here. If I change part of the calculation, I want to see the sum being updated and so on. So that's all I had to say about computed fields. They are great if you have many fields that you want to show as one, and you can always rely on the fact that they are reactive in the sense that all dependencies will trigger, as we saw here in this code to the right. We can see that the sum and full address are being invoked if one of the dependent fields are being changed. So that's kind of good to know as well.